In today's video, we're going to show you how you can quickly change the direction of a three-phase motor.
I'll stop you there, Gary. How do you slowly change the direction of a three-phase motor?
I would suggest on site you are paid by the hour. So if we take the cover off here and we disconnect two of the phases and we swap their positions, we can change the direction of the motor. All that process could be done actually in the plug itself.
Yeah, good. And if you work in plant maintenance, you've got to make that process sound really complex so you can take a long time to do it. But this product that I didn't know existed until Scame sent us one makes that process really easy if you're in a situation where reverse phases can cause a problem. So probably best have a little look at the setup here, Gary, because I've been on a well-known online auction site and bought this three-phase induction motor here with a gearbox on the end. I think it's probably off a conveyor or something like that, so we can actually see the motor turning a little bit slower than it would normally do. Coupled to that, I've got this 32 amp plug and socket combination, and I would suggest normally it wouldn't be a 1.5 millimeter flexible cable on the outside of it. I've just that's possibly a little bit overkill the socket for this, but I have got the correctly sized motor overload protective device there, which is a starter and overload, and that works. That works really well.
And you know it works because obviously when you first connected up the motor, it was connected in delta, worked for a little while, didn't it? 3 or 4 seconds, and then obviously tripped out the overload, and you've changed that over now to star. Do you want to start it up for us and see it rotating? So we've got a clockwise rotation on that, which might be fantastic, but it just depends, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. So this, yes, imagine the scenario. You're on a building site. You've got a three-phase cement mixer, Gary.
Right, three-phase cement mixer. Okay, yeah. So obviously it's got to rotate in the correct direction for those blades to make that mixing. And say it's going the other way around, I've got a little scenario for you now. Does that mean I can take some concrete, throw it into the mixer if it's going in reverse, and it spits out sand, gravel and cement at me?
Yeah, it's like those three-phase heaters when they go in the wrong direction that put out cold air. No, obviously, yeah, you do need to get the right phase rotation. And a piece of plant like that that's moving around between different sites,
yes,
that's where you're probably going to have, you know, repetitive problems with phase rotation. Really, you don't want, you know, builders and electrics don't normally mix, do they?
No, we don't want their intervention. We don't want them taking off covers and start turning over conductors into different places. So we're going to make that process easier by using this Scame plug, but they also do them as the inlets as well, don't they?
Yeah, so this is a phase rotation plug, and it's got a really clever device in there that allows you to quickly swap over two phases, and that's an easy process. In the front here is a place you put your screwdriver in, that pushes a plunger back,
okay,
and then you can then just turn it and then swap over the phases, release it, and that's it, job done.
So the screwdriver's actually not going anywhere near the terminals, it's just flicking those phases over mechanically.
Yeah, and obviously because it's inside this part of the plug, you can't do that live. You know, you've got to actually physically disconnect the equipment. Yeah, so that's a really, you know, quick way of solving that problem. They also, as I say, have it on the inlet as well, so it could be, yeah, it's another piece of mobile equipment where you're plugging into, and it's probably extension leads and things like that that are probably going to cause you the most problems. You'd like to think that whoever did the original installation has checked phase rotation.
Having changed over those two phases, Gordon, I expect this now to rotate in an anti-clockwise direction.
There you go, as if by magic. So a little closer look at the plug itself. It's available in a few different options. So this is the 32 amp version with three pole neutral and earth. It is also available with three pole and earth in also a 16 amp version as well, and two IP ratings, IP66, 67 or an IP44 version for both the plug and the inlet options. Great bit of engineering. You know, everything as you expect, good cord grip, and it is also marked on the side. If you don't look in the barrel, but you can see it is a phase reverse plug clearly marked on there.
Well, what a simple idea that we didn't know existed. However, we'd love your feedback if you've had any issues with sending a three-phase machine in the wrong directions. Also, during this video, I noticed that one of us can't tell the difference between a plug and a socket, and if you're the same, check out the video just here.
Yeah, connector is if you want to de-risk your terminology.